Did you know we might have missed one important detail from the Star Trek Picard Season 3 trailer? While many are focused on the fact Star Trek The Next Generation's cast are back and in their new uniforms for the upcoming third season, we've got confirmation from Sir Patrick Stewart that we'll be seeing multiple Enterprises. Yes, you heard me right, multiple Enterprises. How does this work? Let's explore more. Welcome to Trek Central, I'm your host Captain Jack, and let's get straight into the video. Now, as a quick heads up, we're very close to 100k subscribers here on the YouTube channel. It'd mean the world to us if you make sure to hit that subscribe button and hit that like button as well. Okay, let's make it so. Before we dive into each main Enterprise contender for the appearance, we'll be talking about a few things. First, let's recap what Sir Patrick Stewart actually said. During the Star Trek Universe San Diego Comic-Con panel, Stewart said, "We'll see more than one Enterprise." So it gets a little confusing, but we did revisit the old Enterprise for a time. So we've got more than one USS Enterprise. Also, old Enterprise? Does this mean we might be revisiting either the Enterprise E or in fact the destroyed Enterprise D? Who knows? We have some theories and information on what each Enterprise is actually doing in the Star Trek universe. Let's explore more and get you up to date. Now, our obvious Enterprise has to be the Sovereign class Enterprise E, previously commanded by Jean-Luc Picard following the destruction of the Galaxy class Enterprise D. However, where is the starship? It's been absent from modern Star Trek media, especially with it not being present in Season 1 or 2 of Star Trek Picard. Last we officially saw the Enterprise E in Star Trek canon is it was being repaired in dry dock, following a deadly battle with Shinzon of Remus. This is where we last see the Enterprise E. Since then, we've not heard or seen the actual ship on our screens. However, its lore has been expanded in Star Trek books, comics, and such. In extended canon, such as Star Trek Picard novel, The Last Best Hope by Una McCormack, we learn that Jean-Luc Picard left the Enterprise E along with Geordi LaForge in 2381. Picard was promoted to Admiral to deal with a Romulan relocation crisis due to their star about to go supernova. Thus, this left the Enterprise without a captain. The comic book series, Star Trek Picard Countdown, also hints at who took over the captaincy of the Enterprise E. This would, of course, be Mr. Worf. Worf would find himself promoted to captain of the Federation's flagship, and be the commanding officer for the Enterprise E from 2381 onwards. However, we've never seen this on screen or know many details about Worf commanding the starship, so there's a little bit of a grey area. Will we see the Enterprise E in Star Trek Picard Season 3? It is possible. Creators know how important the ship is not just to Jean-Luc Picard, but also to the TNG crew and the fans. However, showrunner Terry Matalas might have left a little hint slip through. When we look at the new promotional art for Worf, he is wearing a Starfleet Command uniform, but also has a Captain rank pips on his shoulder. Matalas has since confirmed via Twitter that Worf is not a captain. Make of that what you will. Whether he perhaps means that Worf is not a captain in Season 3, yet he may be in flashbacks, that could be better. As a quick note, we've covered the history of the Enterprise E in other videos. Some extended canon items, such as the MMO video game Star Trek Online, list the Enterprise E as eventually destroyed. However, this does not connect with the mainline canon, currently, so keep that in mind. What about revisiting old Enterprises? Well, Sir Patrick could have been talking about the Enterprise D, especially if there was a new Enterprise, which we'll discuss shortly. But first, we've got to consider the legendary Galaxy-class Enterprise D. If a ship is destroyed, how do we revisit a destroyed ship? Sure, time travel is one thing, and we might have had enough of that with the second season of Picard. Could the Enterprise D be revisited? Actually, yes, it could. Even though the starship was lost in the film Star Trek Generations, not all of the ship was actually destroyed. As revealed by Star Trek Picard Season 2 in a nifty little background detail, the saucer section of the Enterprise D was eventually recovered by Starfleet. The damaged section has wound up in the Starfleet Museum by the time of Picard Season 2. Thus, it is possible for the Next Generation crew and Picard to revisit the old ship and walk down memory lane. Of course, flashbacks are always something worth exploring as well. In a Star Trek novel called The Return, it featured the saucer section of the Enterprise D being dismantled and removed from Viridian 3, the crash site. This is because of a pre-industrial civilization on Viridian 4. Civilization? You got what I said. They would eventually venture to the planet in the future and potentially discover the wreck, thus upsetting and breaking the Prime Directive. It makes sense that the Enterprise D would be revisited for Star Trek Picard. We've already had it make a cameo appearance in Season 1 during one of the first opening scenes of the series. However, that was simply a dream sequence for Jean-Luc Picard. Also, there was a hologram of it at Starfleet headquarters in 2399. When we think about Star Trek Next Generation, the Enterprise-D is the center point. But with it being destroyed, the idea of it being seen again is very far-fetched and unlikely. But with Season 3, it would make a lot of sense to see the old ship once again. Even a quick visit with the crew to an old museum to see the saucer section would be fantastic. Perhaps an official decommissioning thing. The idea of the next Enterprise has been a discussion among the Star Trek fandom for some time now. In Star Trek Online, the Odyssey-class Enterprise F, one of my personal favourite starships, takes place as a successor to the Enterprise E. However, as this is a video game in the extended canon, it does not apply to the current canon of the Star Trek universe. But I'll touch on that in a second. Having the Odyssey class as a future Enterprise has been expected since Season 1. Mainly as during one of the lead-up comic books, Picard Countdown, it actually featured Admiral Picard commanding an Odyssey class starship. This would be during the Romulan relocation mission, where Picard commanded the USS Verity. The fact that an Odyssey has made its way into a comic book is fantastic, and makes it one step closer to being on screen. Many of us expected the ship would appear during a flashback sequence in Picard Season 1. However, that did not happen, unfortunately. Fans expect a new Enterprise in the upcoming third season of the series. Given that the bridge and the set of the Stargazer are being used for another starship, that is not the Stargazer itself. We've also seen set leaks, which we can't show you for obvious reasons, but reveal a new starship that uses the Stargazer bridge set. If you know where to look, the LCARS on master display on one of the set leaks includes a nifty little picture of it, so if you can find it, good luck. Just spoiler warning though. Now this confirms that we might be getting a new ship, or rather a new USS Enterprise, or something along those lines. You know, if I would have a bigger theory for a second, it would be the USS Enterprise arriving under the command of someone like Mr. Worf, or perhaps even Geordi LaForge. Hell, like even be a new character to make it rather cool. That would be rather fantastic when you think about it. But why stop there? We could even see them using the Strange New World sets and show us the bloody NCC-1701. No bloody A, B, D, or C. I got the wrong way around. No bloody A, B, C, or D. This is more unlikely due to the fact Strange New Worlds and Picard film in different countries. But we have seen Frakes in Season 1 on a rebuilt Discovery bridge, so it is somewhat possible. Why the original Enterprise might show up, however, is less likely, as it isn't directly tied to our next generation crew. Perhaps it's visiting a holodeck simulation. That could be rather cool. Anyway, we finally confirm that the Enterprise will play a role in the upcoming third and final season of Star Trek Picard. Initially, it seems that the series did not want to get too close to using the Enterprise or doing anything with it, which is understandable from a certain point of view. However, now is the right time to do this, especially as we're treating Season 3 as the last send-off of the next-gen crew. Featuring a new Enterprise could also be a very, very useful tactic for the future of the Star Trek universe. Think about it. When we look at what the Star Trek fandom wants now, many are very vocal about the idea of more Star Trek series set within the same time era as Star Trek Picard. Personally, I refer to a potential future show as Star Trek 2401, simply because it would make sense to take place around this time zone. Introducing a new Enterprise could be a fantastic way to spin off a new show in the future, as the ship would be given a nice little kickstart off the back of Star Trek Picard. It could even introduce the crew as well. Certainly something to think about, especially as you consider the future of the Star Trek universe, following on from Picard Season 3. So what Enterprise do you want to see in Star Trek Picard? As Sir Patrick Stewart has stated, we'll be seeing multiple. Personally, I'm hoping for a flashy new Enterprise such as the Odyssey class. A man can dream though. If you want to keep up to date on the latest Star Trek news, lore, and more, then make sure to hit that subscriber button to never miss a video from the team here at Trek Central. You can also follow us on social media or join our community Discord server. But for now, I've been Captain Jack. Thank you for watching, and do let me know your theories in the comment section below. Live long and prosper, my friends. Goodbye.